H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Let's understand objects in Salesforce. In Salesforce, objects are categorized in two types, standard objects and custom objects, to identify what all objects are available in org. You need to click on Object Manager. It will show type of available objects. So there will be two types, standard object and custom object. So here you can see these all are standard objects. If I scroll down, so there is one custom object available. So standard objects are pre-installed by Salesforce. You don't need to create these objects. If you want to create another object, so for that you can create custom objects. Now let's first understand what object is, then I will be creating a custom object. So moving to App Launcher, searching for an application Sales. I am opening it in new window. Here you can see various tabs are available. If I click on opportunities, so this tab is associated with an object. So in Salesforce, object is a basically data table. So here you can see various information are displayed. If I click on this list view and select all opportunities, it will show all available records in opportunity object. So this first row is basically a record. Second row is another record. So object is basically used to store different records in Salesforce. So we can say object is a table in Salesforce. Now, if you want to use any standard objects, so those are already available. You can just use them by creating their tabs. If tab is already available, then you can directly use that object. Now let's create a new custom object. To create custom object, you need to click on this button at top right corner. Here you can see one option available, custom object. So click on this button. Now we need to fill these information. So first of all, you need to provide the label. So I'm putting at label as property, plural label as properties. So this plural label will be known as tab label. Then this object name will be object API. API is a unique name for a particular identity or for a particular feature so that you can uniquely identify that in Salesforce. So API name for this object will be property. Then here you can put the description. This is a custom object. Then whenever you will be creating a custom object, so one field will be created automatically. So now what is field? So if I take you to this object opportunities, so here you can see opportunity name, account name, amount, close date, stays. So all these are fields. So field is basically a part of record which stores a particular information. So this record name field will be available automatically whenever you will be creating custom object. So its label will be property name. If you want to modify this, you can erase and you can write any name. It has two data types. One is text. Another one is auto number. So if you select text, so in that case, you can fill text value as property name. If you select auto number, so this auto number will be created automatically whenever you will be creating a record for property object. So here you need to decide two things. One is display format and another is starting number. So let's say the format will be this and starting number will be 01. So this way I provided all required information to create object. There are some optional features available that you can enable as per your requirement. Also, after creation of custom object, you can rearrange these features. So if you skip these features right now, so after creation, you can modify them as well. Now, at last, you can see one option is available that says to create custom tab. So the last checkbox is launch new custom tab wizard after saving this custom object. So if you try to create custom object, you need to create its tab as well. So I am enabling this checkbox and clicking on save. So here you can see custom object is created and here we need to create its tab. So object is already selected. We need to click on this lookup so that we can select a tab style. So you can select any tab style which is appropriate and at the bottom, you can see one option is available as next. So click on this button. So step two says add to profiles. So profile basically decides which user can access this particular tab. So here you can see two options. Apply one tab visibility to all profiles. Apply a different tab visibility to each profile. So right now I'm selecting first option. So tab visibility will be common for all the profiles, that is default on. So moving to bottom right corner and clicking on next. Now it is asking on which app you want to place this tab. So here you can see on sales application, various tabs are available. So if you want to place this custom tab on sales application, so you need to enable that checkbox and you can disable other checkboxes. So I am disabling these checkboxes and I'm going to enable this sales checkbox. So sales application and that too lightning sales. So we have two sales application, one for classic and one for lightning. So you need to enable this checkbox for lightning sales application and you can click on save. So all these applications are standard applications. So similar to objects, like we created custom object, we can also create custom applications. So that I'm going to explain in another session. So here you can see property object is created. Here is the API property __C. Now, if you want to create some fields, you can click on fields and relationships. So right now we can see some fields are already available. So we have two types of objects, standard and custom. Similar to object, we have two types of fields, standard and custom. So these all are standard fields because their API names are not having __C appended. And these are created by Salesforce automatically. So if you want to create custom objects, that is also possible. So I'm going to explain that in another session. So let's check whatever object we created that is available as a tab or not. So I'm moving to sales application, doing a refresh. So we will see whether property tab is available to use or not. So you can click on this more option, and at the bottom you can see properties tab is available. So we provided plural name as properties. So that is available as tab name. So object name is property. So if I go here to details, so you can see singular label is property, that is object label. Properties is used as tab label, and this property underscore underscore C is API name that is denoting it is a custom object. And whenever you will be using this custom object, you need to use this API name. So here this custom object is available. If you want to create new record, so you can click on new and you can fill all the details in the fields. So right now we don't have any field, so we cannot create records. So whenever we will be creating fields, then we can create records. Now, one more thing, if you want to enable these options like enable reports, track activities, track field history, so you can click on edit. So this form will be available again, and you can enable, disable whatever options you want to modify. So whenever you want to change, you can enable the checkbox and click on save. So whatever modification you will be doing, that will be applicable. So this is all about objects in Salesforce.